हेलो माय डियर चिल्ड्रेन, आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड एंड एंजॉयिंग योर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. दिस इज़ अ सब्जेक्ट टीचर ऑफ साइंस. एंड चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ वेरी न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 9, हाउसिंग एंड क्लोथिंग. यस, वी कैन अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज द topic about this chapter. Housing and clothing means in this lesson we will learn about needs for a house, how many rooms in a house, and why do we need clothes, and how many types of clothes are there. So let's start. And children, in our previous chapter we have learned about food for health. We have learned many new things about food for health, like we all need food to live and grow. Food help us to become strong and healthy. And we have learned in that chapter sources of food. And the sources of foods are plants and animals. Like we get vegetables, fruits, cereals and pulses from plants, and the food item like milk, eggs and meat from animals. And we have learned in that chapter that milk makes our bones and teeth strong, and we can make many things like cheese, ghee, butter and curd from milk. And in that chapter we have learned that to be healthy we must eat different kinds of food, like healthy food. What is healthy food? Yes, food that makes our body strong and healthy is called healthy food. And fresh vegetables, fruits, cereals and pulses are all healthy foods. Milk, eggs and meat are also healthy foods that we should eat. And in that chapter we have got to know that we should eat fresh, clean and healthy food. We should not overeat, because overeating is also not good for health. And eating healthy food help us to grow and make us strong. And we should not eat dirty or unhealthy food, because eating lots of chips, sweets, cold drinks and candies is unhealthy. And eating unhealthy food can make us fall ill. So children, in that chapter we have also learned about that how many particular type of food we should take different times of the day. Yes, that is breakfast, lunch, dinner. We usually eat particular type of food that is called meal. And we eat breakfast in the morning, we eat lunch at noon, and we eat dinner at night. Means we take a 3 times food at the day. So this was all about our previous chapter that we have learned. Now come to our very new chapter, that is housing and clothing. So children, come on page number is 80. Here you can see need for a house. We need a house to live in. A house keeps us safe from the hot sun, the cold, the wind and the rain. It also keeps us safe from wild animals. Here you can see, this is the picture of rainy day and this is the picture of cold day and this is the picture of hot day. Rooms in a house. Let us look inside Meeta's house. There are many rooms inside her house. Each room has a different use. A house can have one or more rooms. Yes, there are means a house can have one or more rooms, like more rooms, you know, study room, bathroom, bedroom, living room, dining room, kitchen. And more people lives in a small house and they usually have only one room in their house. So this is the Meeta's room. There is study room, bathroom, bedroom, living room, dining room, kitchen and many more things. Yes. So children, just we have learned that house is very important. Yes, we all need a house to live in, and the house we live in is our home. Here we play, study, relax, and spend time with our family. Our house keeps us safe from the heat, the cold, the rain, and the wind. It also keeps us safe from animals. And house has a roof, walls, doors, and windows. And we have learned many more things, like there are many rooms in a home, in a house, and we use them for different things. Like we sleep in the bedroom, we eat in the dining room, we cook in the kitchen, and we meet our guest in the drawing room. We have a bath in the bathroom, and we must keep our houses neat and clean. So this was all about the house, need of house, and the rooms in a house. Now next come to the need for clothes. Here you can see we wear clothes to cover our bodies, and clothes protect us from the heat, the cold, the wind, and the rain. We wear different clothes at different times. Clothes made of cotton are called cotton clothes. We wear cotton clothes when it is hot, and we get cotton from the cotton plant. Cotton clothes keep our bodies cool. Here you can see, this is the picture of cotton plant. Yes, this is cotton plant, and this is the cotton shirt. Now look here. Clothes made of wool are called woolen clothes, and we get wool mainly from sheep. We wear woolen clothes when it is cold, and woolen clothes keep our bodies warm. We put on shoes and socks to protect our feet. This is the picture of sheep. Here you can see, and this is woolen sweater made up of the wool that we get from sheep. So children, now look at next. When it rains, we need to wear a raincoat or carry an umbrella to protect us from getting wet. Yes, here you can see in this picture it is raining, and this girl is carrying an umbrella, and this boy is wearing a raincoat to protect themselves from getting wet. So children, this was all about this chapter that we have learned today in this video. There are many things, like this topic is all about housing and clothing, means need for a house, that we get to know that we all need a house to live in, and house keep us safe from the hot sun, the cold, the wind, and the rain. It also keep us safe from wild animals. And children, you know what, we all should keep our houses clean, neat and clean, because we should be responsible for our things, that we should keep it at proper place. And you should put your toys back after playing with them. Never leave them lying around. Someone can sleep on them and fall. And in this way, house is a place where we used to live with our family happily. And you know what? In some places, we decorate our homes during festival. So house is a very important thing for everyone, because all living things need a house, like human beings and animals also need a house to live. Okay, now next is need for clothes. We have learned that why do we need clothes. We need clothes to keep our body safe from the heat, the cold, the wind, and the rain. Means we need clothes to cover our body, to protect our body. And there are many types of clothes, like cotton clothes, woolen clothes, silk clothes. And where do we get from these type of clothes, which plants, which animals. We have learned many more things about this chapter. So I hope you have understood. So I'm giving you two tasks. First, you have to read this chapter with the help of your parents and with the help of this video. And second task is you have to make a list of a room that you have in your house, and you have to make a list of type of clothes that you know and you used to wear. That's it for today. Thank you and have a nice day.